what the city of the future looks like depends on the choices made by the city of today and the rest of the world's population. It could be hazard resilient, resource sustainable, and rich in natural capital, a garden city.
It really depends how far we're going to push the sustainable development goals and our target for net zero carbon, where we're living more in harmony with the environment through things like environment sensitive and water sensitive urban design.
The city of the future, I think, really depends upon the decisions that we make today as to what we want those cities to look like. Cities are hubs of innovation, hubs of economic development. They bring people together from a really diverse set of groups and offer a really powerful potential to deliver the sustainable development goals.
Urbanisation allows for more sustainable development by achieving huge economies of scale in the generation and production of essential services and commodities.
If you design a compact city, it can actually be really energy efficient. But we haven't really got that balance yet. We're using more resources than ever before, and we're not necessarily seeing new technology and research findings making its way into mainstream practice.
In bringing people together, into smaller confined areas, large numbers of people, urbanisation gives us the chance to deliver things such as access to basic services, water and energy and food to large numbers of people, potentially in a way that is much greener, much more resilient, much more efficient than we were doing previously.
In Singapore, we've made extensive use of dedicated software and hardware to capture geoscience information and data from natural occurring outcrops, boreholes, and samples. We've then brought these data and information together and synthesized them into a 3D geological model for Singapore.
A key challenge that cities face is their resilience to environmental hazards, whether it's earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, landslides, but also environmental change driven by climate change. Understanding those hazards and the dynamics of those hazards is really critical to inform decision making to improve lives in the city.
In Malaysia, our work has centred around capacity building with our partner, JMG, to improve their understanding of digital workflows, their technical skills and IT infrastructure, such that they are able to collect, store and present geoscience information to critical stakeholders.
We really need new technologies to help in terms of data acquisition and management and visualising that data. So, for example, there's better sensor technologies to be able to monitor the urban environment, better modelling techniques to be able to interpret that data. And then we've got 3D and 4D visualisation systems to help integrate it all and to communicate that understanding in a more meaningful way.
In order for the geology to have any impact, geoscience information needs to be communicated to key decision makers.
Partnerships are integral to our urban projects. We need to think of towns and cities as an integrated ecosystem with lots of interdependencies. And that means bringing everybody who's involved in planning and development together. Each one of us has a particular part to play in providing the right solution. And we don't get a good solution if we don't come together.
For geoscientists to come together and work with urban planners, architects, engineers, ecologists, social scientists, psychologists, to really understand what makes the city resilient, what makes the city sustainable, and to think about how we bring our knowledge together to inform decision making is necessary if we're going to build the cities of tomorrow that protect lives, protect livelihoods, and help to achieve sustainable development.
The whole world is now connected, physically and culturally. The choices we make not only affect ourselves, our family and our neighbour, they also affect people on the other side of the world. Unless we work together at a global scale, nothing we do at a local level will have any lasting impact.
We have to be really mindful though when we're working globally. And we have to understand that each city is individual, not just from its geological perspective, but in terms of its culture, its political framework, what legislation exists. Because one solution that works really well in the UK isn't necessarily going to be appropriate for an international city. So we really have to work in partnership and strengthen those collaborations to get the right result.
I think it's really important to take time to look at what other people have done, to share our knowledge with other cities, but to learn from those cities also so that we can enrich our contributions to the global community as we make cities more resilient and sustainable.